evening. We're super excited to have you. This is one of my favorite times of the year. Christmas, I've been counting down. If you don't have your Christmas shopping done, that's your bad. I've been doing it for a little while, but one of my favorite gifts is when I get to hear our students who work so hard be able to perform for you. And this is an amazing group of directors and students. Some of the most talented people I've ever been around. One of the things I love about our students is they really take Psalm 100 to heart. They make a joyful noise. Now, some of you have been hearing them practice, and maybe it wasn't as joyful at the beginning as it's becoming, right? So sometimes it's a work in progress. But one of the things that I love about it is that they do it for the right reasons. And it's not to glorify them, it's to glorify Christ in all that we do, which is the main reason for the season, is the birth of Christ that we celebrate. Happy birthday, Jesus, right? So as we open up, you might offer a word of prayer, just dedicate this time together, and then with no further ado, we'll be able to listen to these wonderful kids. So Lord, we just thank you for this opportunity to come together. We thank you. Just pause for a moment, because so many of us are so busy running around in so many different activities. But let us just be fully present here in the moment as we listen to our incredible faith-filled lions perform tonight. Give them the strength. Give them the wisdom, give them the knowledge to be able to bring all glory to you and their talents and skills that you give them. But let us also be reminded as families how important it is just to embrace the moments that we have, to have these small windows of the soul that we just fully bring glory to you in all that we do. Let us not, in this busyness of this season, forget the true reason, which is your birth, to come save us and to give us eternal life. Lord, we just thank you and give all glory to you. Everyone said, amen.
Ukrainian bell carol. The second one is Ding Dong Merrily on High, and then we close with Jingle Bells.
Contest is what I call it, and then the students have
have individual competitions. There's one called Honor Band, and that's where the students all audition on the same music for all of private school. And then they take the top placements of those students and combine one mega band. And so it's called an Honor Band because it is such an honor to be in those groups. Our high school just went through that, and this week we will find out who made states. So this is our state Honor Band for the high school right now. And then after that, we will have our solo and ensemble competitions, and students will be doing that in March and April and May if they go to state. So next semester is contest season, so be expecting a lot more music, a lot of group music, but then also our individual music. So we would like to close our portion with Christmas Encore. And it was just today during class, I got to remind them that we are so blessed to be at a school where we can call our concert a Christmas concert. I know of several other friends who work for schools, and they have to title a winter concert or a winter celebration. And we just are so blessed that we have such freedom in Christ, but such freedom to call Christmas what it is. And that is the birth of our Lord Jesus Christ. And so I just thank you so much for attending tonight. Following our concert, I'm going to have each row stand up, so then that's a good picture opportunity if you would like it. And then we'll be sitting over here for our portion. And feel free to grab more hot chocolate as we transition. Oh, after this last song, our percussion will be playing their picture too. So I'll talk about that in a minute. Okay, you ready?
This one, it's fun piece. While they're getting set up, I want to go ahead and introduce myself. Those of you that don't know me, my name is Eddie Jimenez. I'm the high school band director. As Mrs. Thornton mentioned earlier, that's just a job title. We co-teach everything. We start in sixth grade, and we teach every single student from sixth grade all the way up to 12th grade, which is great because a lot of these students, I started back in sixth grade, and I get to see them grow. And Mrs. Thornton, same thing for her. She gets to start back in sixth grade and see their progression all the way up to 12th grade. I just want to say, middle school, I am so proud of you guys. What a great sound, what a great concert. And these guys are incredible, so incredibly proud of them. So we have four songs for you today. We're going to warm up a little bit, and then we're going to play. You guys ready? All right. So you may have noticed we have a new student, a ninth grade transfer. He's got a beard, but not before, he's in ninth grade. He's just got a facial hair problem thing. But I want to introduce you to Mr. Gene Dooley. His weather is affecting everything. We have two trumpet players out, so I call it the last minute favor. And Mr. Dooley said, absolutely, I'd love to come play with you guys to fill in the trumpet section a little bit. But I always love when I get to bring in professional musicians to sit in with the band because there's so much that our students get to learn. for these professional players. And I always try to bring in people who master classes or when I have an opportunity to have somebody sit in and play with them. And it's just a wonderful learning opportunity for them. When I was in school, I went to concerts all the time, and that's one of the best ways to learn. I would sit in concerts. When I was in New York, I'd go watch the New York Philharmonic all the time, and I just learned from so much by watching professional musicians. And I encourage these guys, hey, anytime you meet a professional musician, you need to go up to them and say, hey, how do you do what you do? How do you practice? How can I be more like you? How can I sound like you? So it's a great opportunity that we have Mr. Gene joining us. And then, of course, we have Mr. Kovar, who's hiding over here, who's an incredible percussionist. He's just unbelievable. And he has single-handedly transformed the culture of the drumline and the percussion for both middle school and high school. I don't know if you knew this, but 5 years ago, our drumline consisted of one bass, one oboist holding a bass, and one snare drum. And that's it. And Mr. Kovar, I tell him all the time, I said, I'm going to have to put a cap on how many percussion. Everybody wants to play percussion. Everybody wants to study with Mr. Kovar. So I told him, dude, I mean, that's enough. You can't have any more players. I need some more players. But all of our kids love Mr. Kovar, who has really transformed single-handedly the culture of the percussion here at PCA, as well as the culture of the band program. We are blessed to have him. And then, of course, Mrs. Thornton, the one and only incredible band director. I'm so lucky that I get to work with her every single day. She's in charge. I just do what she tells me to do. But seriously, I love working with her. She's an incredible band director. And we're just so blessed to have all these teachers and all these guests here at PCA. You want to hear more music?
Yeah.
All right, do you have any money? Our fine arts director is not here, so I drew the short end of the stick. Mrs. Thorne and I were, you know, playing paper, rock, scissors back there to figure out who's going to talk to you about Friends of the Arts. But Friends of the Arts, it is, if you donate money to Friends of the Arts, depending on the amount you give, you become Friends of the Arts. And that, the money that you give goes into one account and gets spread evenly into all the fine arts here at PCA. So if you would like to become a Friend of the Arts, all you have to do is you can email me or email Mr. Rutherford. Probably easiest to email me since you have my contact info, and we'll put you in touch with him. But here at PCA, everything that we do in the fine arts is through donations. So your donations are greatly appreciated. If you would like to become, once again, Friends of the Arts, email me and we'll give you more information on that. Also, I want to tell you guys, I'm going to give you a big thank you. So our March-a-thon, our goal is $19,000, and we have raised just a little bit under $18,000. We're so close, and I'm very grateful for your hard work, because I know that it's you guys donating to our band program, and I know it's your connections donating to our band program. With the Gold Card fundraiser, we have raised $15,000. So we have made a ton of money this year, and it has been a true blessing. And the organizations have enhanced the student experience in our band program. I want to show off a little bit of all the instruments that we've bought. All that money that we receive immediately gets put right back into the program. And one great example is, if you need that, after the concert, come up here, we'll show you if you can't see. But we bought a set of timpani. That's $15,000 right there, brand new timpanis. Then we bought this beautiful rosewood marimba. Seriously, you gotta come up here and look at this thing. I do a little bit of woodworking on the side just for fun, and I'm just I'm fascinated by the work on that. So it's a rosewood 5-octave marimba. It's an absolute beauty. That was another $14,000. We bought all new field frames for marching band. So field frames here is a perfect example. This is a field frame. We have all of our melodic, all of our percussion equipment that we take out on the field is on these field frames because it protects the instrument and it's just a lot easier to move. If you've seen our marching band show, we actually wheel out the drum set in the middle of the field, and we have our percussionists play the drum set in the middle of the field and then wheel them back out. So this is a field frame. This thing is indestructible. We spent another $10,000 on that. And it's all because of you and your hard work. Our band program just did a big, in our band hall, big renovation. See what's going on. But in the back, we have a brand new storage unit for percussion that Mr. Tolbert designed. And so now every single percussion instrument has a place to live. Before, it was just kind of like, you walk in your own tent, stuck on your foot, you know? But now everything has a place to stay, to live, as well as new cabinets that we put in to free up a lot of the space that was used up in the back room. So now Mr. Tolbert has a what used to be a storage room, now that is a percussion practice room, and have everything stored away, and that was $38,000. So every single penny that we make, that we receive from donations, we consider that to be a blessing, and we put that right back into the program. And these are just a few examples of how we're using that money. We've bought two brand new French horns, we've bought a couple of tubas, I think we're up to 4 tubas, because our program is growing, so we have more tuba players than we get tubas, so we had to invest in a couple of tubas. And if I'm forgetting anything, Mrs. Thornton, give me a shout, a brand new snare drum. I mean, it's just, once again, we are grateful to you because I know this is your hard work and it's you reaching out to your friends for donations, and it really is a true blessing. This band program went from raising zero money 5 years ago to last year we raised $45,000, and this year we're well over $30,000 raised. So thank you, Union.
Thank you.
have, much like Mrs. Thornton, we have our chili cook-off coming up next semester, and we have our contest and cycling, which is our evaluation, and that's also in the spring. Tomorrow, we're going on a tour, I call it a tour of the North Campus in Bonton. We're taking the band up to the North Campus, and we're going to play for the North Campus kids. The choir is also coming with us, and we're going to have a couple of the North Campus band kids join us and play with us. I believe that music is a gift from God, and we are the vessel that He uses to spread that gift. This is why I do music. It's why I love music, because when I play music, it's not me. It's something that God created, and He's using me. He's using all of these students to give you something. And that's the gift that we want to take to the students at the North Campus, as well as the students in Bonton. The students in Bonton won't have the opportunity, because of their circumstances in life, don't have the opportunity to see live music. And we want to show them what blessing it is, live music, and what opportunities they have in life if they set their minds to it. We just want to pour our blessings upon both the North Campus and the Bonton students. And it's just such an amazing opportunity and such a wonderful experience every year that we get to do this. In Bonton, we actually used to take a tour of Bonton. We used to go to about four, five, six different senior homes and play for them. And then we would go to the King's Academy. We haven't been able to do that in a couple of years because of COVID, so we only play at the King's Academy in Bonton. We are hoping that in the future we are able to resume our tour of Bonton and play for five or six different senior homes as well as the school. I want to point out this little guy over here. Stand up. This is Noah Davis. He's our resident genius. As a sixth grader, he was in the high school all-region band, and he was one chair away from making the all-state band. He plays about five or six different instruments, more than one. Around there, five or six different. He's in seventh grade, and he played this concert on one rehearsal. So I just want to show him off a little bit. We're so proud of him. And then one more big shout out about the marching band winning state 2 years in a row. Now the pressure is on for a third. Hey, you guys want to do some jazz? Do you have some money?